the Black Mamba lives in us all. Long live the Black Mamba.
This is a melody.
Baby, welcome to the party. I'm off the Myers and the lean. That's why I'm over retarded.
That's why I'm over retarded.
Baby, welcome to the party.
Huh?
I hit the boy up and then I go skating around it. Baby, welcome to the party. Pitch him a thot, give me lick.
Gun on my
head.
One in the
head. Send in the clip.
Baby. Baby, baby,
baby.
Baby, don't trip.
Just lower your tone.
Lower your tone.
Cause you can get hit.
Yeah, so today's the kickoff of the Shots Audition. Again, we're going on a Shot Audition tour that started today, April 6, 2019, in Atlanta, Georgia. What better place to start, you know, this movie audition than Hot Atlanta, you know, where videography and production is booming and skyrising. But not only that, Dr. King's from Atlanta, Georgia. And not only that, like I said, this is the actual weekend of his assassination. Going into the journey of the Shot, but in this story, I will tell everything that led up to the assassination. A lot of people think it was some famous journalist or famous photographer who captured that memorable, you know, photo of Dr. King, you know, entourage as they pointed up in the direction of, you know, where they thought the shot had rang from, you know, as Dr. King laid on the ground in a pool of blood. And again, it was Joseph Lau, this young South African photographer. I'm gonna paint the picture, I'm gonna tell the story, and I'm excited. I'm excited to see the, you know, response, you know, from the people, you know, the world. Again, as I tell a legend, as I tell a story. So yeah.
So we here in Atlanta, Georgia, at the historical Martin Luther King Jr. National History Park. We gonna ride through today, you know, just show you where a lot of my inspiration came from. From making the shot, being born in Atlanta, raised in Atlanta. I come from the same neighborhood as Martin Luther King. A lot of y'all don't know that. I mean, it's a lot growing up in Atlanta, Georgia, and, you know, again, having strong influencers like Dr. King and Andrew Young and John Lewis, and just all the, you know, the great civil rights activists and leaders. I say this is a very historical street right here. This is where I'm from Fort Ward. They refer to it in Atlanta like in the map, or like in the, I guess, the pamphlets when you come to Atlanta as Old Fort Ward, but it's really Fort Ward. And that's where I'm from, Atlanta, Georgia. Interesting enough, that's where Martin Luther King would be from, Fort Ward, you know? In certain jurisdictions throughout America, people go by either their zones or their wards, like what zone of the city you live in or what ward you live in. And like I said, in my area, it's Fourth Ward.
Atlanta is a home to all type of individuals, all type of breed of people, ethnicities, all of that. And that's what I love about Atlanta, Georgia. Over here, like just old homes that were in Martin Luther King's neighborhood. Like literally, like these are like homes that they kept, you know, just to, you know, keep that essence of old Atlanta, Georgia. And over here is actual Martin Luther King's house. I got a crazy story. I never forget, I was 8, 9 years old. I was going to the Catholic school around the corner, Our Lady of Lourdes. And I never forget, my mom dropped me off at school one day, and she didn't know that, you know, it was some type of Catholic holiday she wasn't aware of. And she dropped me off at school, and she usually would just drop me off and I would walk on up the hill into the school room. And that's what she did, you know, regular tradition, how she dropped me off. And school was closed. And I never forget, the sheriff, she saw me. I guess she saw how young I was. She was like, little boy, you know, school is closed. Where's your mommy? You know, I told her what, you know, what the situation was. My mom had dropped me off.
So she was like, okay, well, we're gonna go call your mom, but first you have to just, you know, walk with me over to the house, because I have to do something, get ready for a tour. And we come up to the Martin Luther King house, and, you know, she sets everything up, change light bulbs, do things of that nature, and she gets ready for a tour. And it was kind of cool. I was just in Martin Luther King house with this really cool, I guess, sheriff type park, historical park ranger. But it was an interesting experience. Dr. King, he fought for all of this city. You know, Dr. King made it happen for this whole city. You know, a lot of his work definitely was, you know, contributed to the city of Atlanta, Georgia. And I appreciate that a lot about Dr. King. And there's so many other reasons why I appreciate Dr. King. Dr. King showed me how to stand up for what I believe in, showed me what it was like being a man, a leader. So, you know, Dr. King definitely affected my life and, you know, my decisions, and I thank him a lot for it. It's a great day today. I wish, you know, the sun was out so you guys can really see how the city shine and glisten. You know, people come down here to Atlanta for all type of reasons. Yes, you got the historical Martin Luther King Park to check out, but a lot of people come down here for a good time too, because you have the Mercedes-Benz Stadium for all your Falcon games. You have the Phillips Arena for all your Hawks game. And you got Centennial Park. You have some of the home of the strip clubs. It's known to have a lot of strip clubs throughout the city. And it's a lot of reasons why people tend to move. It's a great place to raise a family. It's great homes, great culture. Through His Eyes, that's the name of this piece. It's a morbid tribute to John Wesley Dobbs, you know. This is a really dope piece in Atlanta. It's a part of the King Historic District. And the King Historic District, that's Auburn Avenue. It's a lot of bars, a nice nightlife, a lot of great restaurants. A great place to, you know, come hang out and chill. This is the house I grew up in. You know, this house is 100 years old. Like, literally, my great grandfather, rest his soul, Ulysses, he showed me the deed to the home, and it's 100 years old. I remember being young and running up and down this sidewalk with my brothers and sisters and, you know, all my friends in the neighborhood. You know, the family sitting on the porch just looking at us, just picking up, grabbing whatever I could find on the ground. But again, I'm literally a mile away from the Dr. King home where he was born and raised, and in the yard he ran around. So this is the yard I ran around as a child. And Dr. King, 6-7 blocks up, ran around a different yard. So yeah. Like I said, this house has a lot of history, a lot of moments, a lot of stories. It's the house right here. Companies that come through, they build these big, you know, beautiful high rises. And again, the people of the old neighborhood usually tend to either sell, go elsewhere, or they're bought out. So it's just a blessing to be able to keep the house in the family name and continue the legacy. You know, same way Dr. King did, he continued the legacy, you know, through his children and through his, you know, his story. Yeah, that's what I'm here to do. Think greatly. Thinking great, you can accomplish some great things in life and go great places and see great things and be around great people. I personally feel so when you think greatly, you're gonna accomplish great things. And this is the type of message that Dr. King preached to the people. And that's the word I got from it. We will not be satisfied until justice rolls down like water and righteousness like a mighty stream. And then like literally goes into their tombstone. So that's how much the Kings meant to Atlanta, Georgia. They were royalty. You know, they were a high class people that, you know, walked for everybody. And when I say high class again, because again, their worth, their contributions to the city is nothing but high class, high status when you put others before yourself. You know, that's definitely something to admire and something that you gotta find admirable. And that's what these people did, the Kings. You know, they put a lot of people before themselves. and I'm definitely one of those people who can appreciate that. The legacy and the story he left behind is something that will never be erased, never be forgotten, and that's why I decided to move forward with making the shot. You know, again, I want to continue to tell that story of a man who stood up for not just me and my daughters and my family, but for many of us, and many of us that look all type of different ways, not just blacks, you know, whites, Hispanics. Again, he stood up for the people. Again, the Poor People Campaign wasn't, yes, the African-American race was definitely a part, you know, population was definitely a part of the Poor People Campaign, but again, it was a lot of poor people throughout America, and it still is in the economy. And Dr. King stood up for that. He wanted to go against that. We watched the rich get richer and the poor get poor, and also going through injustice ways and practices to even get rich. So I like what Dr. King did. Again, the shot, it's a beautiful story. Joe Salo had a great story. I'm excited, like I said, to combine the two. And we making magic, we making history. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that.